Hey, Blues fans, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley's Free Lesson Friday again. Hey, this week I'm just going to teach that kind of jump blues style rhythm. It's kind of reminiscent of Gimme Back My Wig, but in a different key and a little bit different tempo. Reason I'm teaching this is that this week I hopped on the Instagram and fired up one of my amps here and was playing a little ditty like that, and got some good comments. People seemed to like it. Somebody asked me to teach a lesson on it, and since I didn't have anything else planned for this Friday, I decided I'd do it. Now, having said that, I am working on kind of a jump blues course that I hope to have out by the end of October. Don't hold me to that, but it's basically going to be focused on more those kind of jump blues style rhythms, and then there will be like a performance and breakdown and all that good stuff. But anyway, this lesson will kind of get you in the mood. Let's talk about where we're at. We're going to be in the key of B. I'm in standard tuning here. So what we're going to do for this rhythm pattern, that's kind of our lead, and we're going to slide. Imagine an E-form chord for the one here. Slide in to the major third here at the eighth fret of the G string. And then back and forth between 7 and 9 on the B string. And then we're going to bar the 7th fret of the E and the B string. I'm going to strum that 4 times with a little bit of a hiccup in our step. And then 2 staccato hits with the 9th fret of the B string and the 7th fret of the E string. Okay? And there's that little hiccup in between. Okay, now that is kind of the bare bones of it. What makes a rhythm like this great is not just the notes that you're playing, but the other stuff that you add in. So if you imagine keeping that whole chord fretted here, and basically you're just playing the chord from the D string down. And the way that you get that staccato sound when it's all these notes is that as soon as you play it, you just release your fingertips. All right, and then when we go to the 4 chord, it's going to take us up here to the 12th fret, and we're just going to repeat the same thing in this position. Except that we're not going to do that exactly. When we're up here at the 4, we're going to create a little bit of open-ended tension. And we're going to move, instead of this last hit being these notes barred at the 12th fret, we're going to move this note at the 14th fret up to the 15th. And we're going to do that for both times over bars 5 and 6. And you can apply the same principle here of fretting, you know, all the notes from the D string down to that chord. And that creates a little bit of kind of open-ended tension. Then we drop down to the 1 chord at bar number 7 and we kind of resolve it. Because this sounds more like an ending than that kind of sounds like a voice going up, asking a question. That kind of sounds like a question or answer. And then we repeat that over bar 8. Now over the 5-4, bars 9 and 10, we're going to slide up here to the 5 chord at the 14th fret. And we're going to repeat kind of the opening ended tension here. And so we're going to, instead of going like that, we're going to go, we're going to slide up there. So here we're at the 14th fret. I'm not calling out all the fret names because I want to make sure you realize it's the same relative pattern. Okay, it's just that we're rooted right here at the 14th fret. So over the 5 chord, drop to the 4 chord at bar number 10. Again, end with that kind of question there, and then at bar number 11, we're kind of answering. Now, this particular rhythm doesn't have, I think, enough space for a turnaround. If you tried to shove one in there, it's just kind of a weird, this is just one of those songs where I think it actually feels better just to kind of wrap it around at the end by playing through bar 12 there with no turnaround. But one thing to keep in mind is that this can create havoc if you're playing it in a band situation, if the other musicians are not paying attention. Because what happens is that we get down here to the 1 chord at bar number 11. We just finished up. There's no break. Now we're at bar 1 of the next chorus, and we got 4 bars over the 1. That creates a 6-bar stretch over the 1 chord. The break in the chorus happens after the second 1. So bars 10, 11 and 12, same pattern over the 1 chord. And then a new chorus starts, but there's no kind of delimiter to kind of mark, hey, here's the end and start of a new chorus. So if you're playing this with a band or playing it with other people, make sure they know not to kind of daydream through the end of a progression, because you really need to feel, you know, inside in your internal clock that a new chorus is starting, because you don't hear that audible reminder. So there you have it. It's a little jump blues rhythm that you can play. Move to different keys. And it works well. A couple different tempos. But I think it sounds best right around there. I think we're at about 195 beats per minute or something like that. Anyway, like I said, there will be a course coming out soon that teaches more kind of jump blues rhythm. And then hopefully a performance if I can get that course finished too. Anyway, if you're new to Texas Blues Alley, be sure to check out all of Free Lesson Friday over at texasbluesalley.com. Got lessons on a bunch of different topics, skill levels, enough to keep you busy for a long time. And if you're really serious, don't just be a tourist at Texas Blues Alley. Why don't you move there and become a TXBA local? Locals get the best of Texas Blues Alley, all the courses, all the time, fantastic features in our online player. And they even get a 30% discount if they ever want to buy any courses to keep. It is good to be a local. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the lesson. Until next time, thanks for watching.